We are back together again. It's so nice to see you here, watching live on the internet.
Here we go again. We are back again. It is English Addict Extra, a little extra slice of English, coming to you live from the birthplace of the English language, which just happens to be... Ooh, it's England. We are back, everyone. I hope you are feeling good today. Hi, everybody. This is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you feeling happy? I want to see that smile on your face now, please. After three, one, two, three, smile. Plenty of reasons to smile today. First of all, I'm here. How could your day be bad? I'm here right now on your screen. And my name is Mr. Duncan. I am one of those strange people who like to pop up from time to time on YouTube and do all sorts of things. I love the English language. In fact, you might say that I am one of those up there. I am an English addict, and yes, I do like English, and I have a feeling that you do as well, because that is the reason why we are all here together. I talk about the English language. I've been doing this for ever such a long time, many, many years, in fact. This year, 16 years. I would imagine there are people who were only small or young, very young, or maybe even not born when I started doing this on YouTube. Isn't that amazing? So here we are then. Hey, yes, guess what? We've made it all the way to the middle of another week. Things are getting rather tense in certain parts of the world, certain areas, certain countries. I know, and you know what I'm talking about, but at least we are all still here together for now. Yes, it's Wednesday. I always think one of the things I like to see on my computer screen, besides my smiling face and your smiling face, is some lovely fireworks. Yes, let's have a celebration. It is a new day. A new day has arrived. I hope your day is good. Today we are having some gorgeous weather. The sun is out. It's quite warm as well. It would appear that we are heading towards another period of warm weather. More hot weather is on its way. And of course, during this month, the month of August, oh, by the way, hello everyone, welcome to August. This is my first live stream in the month of August 2022. So I hope you are feeling good today. I'm not too bad. It is hot in the studio once again. I don't know why. I think I might have to get some air conditioning for this room because it's boiling hot again. I think it's about 33 degrees in the studio. Outside, the temperature is around 23 Celsius. So in the studio, very hot. Outside, not too bad. Although we did have a lot of rain last night as well. I don't remember any of it because I was fast asleep. I had a great night's sleep last night. I don't know what happened, but I was so tired when I went to bed, and I slept completely. You might say that I had a solid sleep. Solid. That means your sleep was undisturbed. At no point during the night did you wake up. You were not moving around. You were not tossing and turning during the night. You were sound asleep, fast asleep. You had a beautiful night's sleep. And that's what happened last night. Hello to everyone. Welcome. All aboard, everyone. All aboard. This is the train to English Town. And that's where we are heading right now. Live English every Sunday and Wednesday from 2 p.m. UK time. Oh, did you see my new video? I posted a video on my YouTube channel yesterday. I was out and about on Monday. I couldn't resist going outside on Monday for two reasons. First of all, it was the first day of August, and also the weather was incredible. So I could not resist going outside on Monday, the 1st of August, and had a walk around in the lovely sunshine. And that video is available to view on my YouTube channel, along with all the rest of them that I've been making over the past 16 years. Can you believe it? I can't believe I've been doing this for nearly 16 years. By the way, there is a wasp in the studio. It's buzzing around my head, and it's very distracting. So if I seem a little bit distracted today, that is because there is a wasp buzzing around my head. I might try to move that wasp outside, just in case it comes across and stings me on my nose. Yes, we have the live chat. Hello, live chat. Nice to see you here as well. Of course, it would not be the live stream without you on the live chat. We have some lovely views to look at today. We have some nice flowers, some very interesting plants that are growing in my garden at the moment. Because, of course, it is summer here, and a lot of things are looking very colourful and beautiful at the moment in the garden. Oh, hello, Mohsen. Oh, interesting. Mohsen is first once again on today's live chat. I have a feeling that Mohsen might be the new champion. I think so. Congratulations, Mohsen. You are first on today's live chat. Big hello to Mohsen. It's nice to see you here today, and congratulations for being first on the live chat. We also have, oh, also joining us today, we have all together now, Luis Mendez is here today. Hello, Luis. Nice to see you here. Vitas is in third place. I'm afraid you only get the bronze medal. We also have Zenek. Hello, Zenek. Nice to see you here. Galu is here as well. We have Magdalena is here as well. By the way, do you like my new T-shirt? This is a T-shirt that I had made last week, and it is something that I'm trying, something that I'm experimenting with. That's all I'm saying. So here is a T-shirt that I had made especially for me last week. So I'm going to show you now. You've never seen it before. It's the first time that I've showed it to you. I will take a step back so you can see my T-shirt clearly. And it says, I am an English addict. I'm not saying anything else, but I will give you a little clue. You might be able to get your very own English Addict t-shirt. How does that sound? That's all I'm saying for now. I'm not giving anything else away, but I am at the moment in negotiations to get myself some merchandise. Mr. Duncan, you are just like all the other big celebrities on YouTube with their merchandise. So we will see what happens anyway. I'm just experimenting at the moment. It is nothing official. If once I decide what I'm going to do, I will let you know. But I thought I would show you this today to give you a little taste. So now you know what I am. I am an English addict through and through. Hello also Claudia. Hello to Claudia. I suppose I should say, what's cooking Claudia? What have you got in your pot? What's cooking Claudia? Is it something spicy and hot? Is it something salty or not? Oh Claudia, what is in the pot? What do you have in your pot today? What are you cooking for this Wednesday? Oh, I suppose I should say congratulations as well to the ladies' football team, England, the England Lionesses. They really did roar the other night. They beat Germany. Was it 2-1? I think it was, wasn't it? It went into extra time. And I think the final score was 2-1. Well done to the Lionesses. Women's football. It is something that has been promoted quite a lot over the past 2 or 3 years. And now it would appear that it is official. Women's football is here to stay, apparently. Although I do have a feeling that lots of men like to watch the women's football just in case they have a celebration kiss. I think that's what it is. So when they score a goal, they all come together and maybe they hug and maybe some of them will kiss. And I think that's why many of the men are watching. And if that is the reason, how dare you? How dare you? As Greta Thunberg would say, if I can find it. Where has it gone? Come on, Greta, where are you? Oh, there it is.
How dare you?
Thank you, Greta. It's been such a long time since I've heard from Greta. What's happened to Greta? I think she may have grown up into a big girl now. I think so. So maybe she's decided to do something else with her life. Hello also to Zudzika. Hello, Zudzika. Nice to see you here today. But on a serious note, congratulations to the England football team, women's football, men's football. It's all good fun, apparently. Hello, Otterbeck. Hello to you as well. Nice to see you here today on the live chat. We have a busy one coming up. Today, we are looking at words and phrases connected to something quite simple. However, you might be surprised to find out just how complicated it is. We are looking at words and phrases connected to way, W-A-I. And we will be looking at that a little bit later on. Anything else to mention? Oh, yes. Some good news, everyone. Guess what has returned to the back of the house? They have returned. The cows have come back. Can you believe it? So we thought that they had gone. But apparently the farmer had taken them to another field nearby. And so a couple of days ago, I was surprised to find that the cows were actually back in the field. And they're there. They are actually there again. They've returned. This time there are 6 of them. 5 black cows and 1 brown cow. I haven't had a chance to film them yet, but they are outside at the back, feeding busily. Hello also to, oh, Beatrice. Beatrice says, nice news. You will be an uncle soon. Is that me? Are you talking to me, or is this someone else? I wonder. No, the live stream was not late today. I was on time. I started today's live stream on time. I know on Sunday I was late, but I had a very good excuse why I was late on Sunday. As you know, I went to a wedding party last weekend, and let's just say we went to bed very late, and I was feeling a little rough in the morning. Hello, Abu Ghali. Hello to you. Nice to see you here as well. I can't read Arabic, unfortunately, but thank you for joining me anyway. It's very nice to see you here. Try not to melt in the studio, Mr. Duncan. I will try not to melt here today, but it's so hot in the studio. Hello also to Bruno. Hello, Bruno. Nice to see you here. Hello, Mr. Duncan. But I don't want to say hello to the wasp. I think it's gone now. I think the wasp has gone. I think it's flown out the window, which is good news for me. Hello also to, who else is here today? Oh, hello to Inaki. Nice to see you here as well. Lewis says, have you been told off by the farmer when you are walking along or walking among his wheat? Ah, well, if you remember, a few years ago, I got into a lot of trouble when I was filming some sheep in one of the farmer's fields around here. I got into a lot of trouble. One of the farmers came over and he was very angry with me. He was not a happy farmer, let's just say. However, yes, on Monday I was out and about walking around the cornfield, and I suppose sometimes it's very hard to resist walking amongst the crop, especially when it's beautiful. There is nothing nicer than a wheat field that is there in front of you, and it's very hard to resist walking through it. You really want to. You can't stop yourself. It is almost like something you can't stop yourself from doing. So yes, I did walk through the field, but fortunately the farmer did not see me. And one of the things that I have to remember about living around here is many of the farmers also have guns as well, which does not fill me full of much joy, to be honest, when I'm walking around. I always wonder sometimes if one day I'm going to get shot by a local farmer. maybe not. Hello also, Ibrahim. Nice to see you here as well. A lot of people joining in today. Hello. If it is your first time on the live chat, please tell me and I will say a special hello to you as well. The cows have come back. Yes, they have. They've returned. And I will try to film them this week for Sunday. I will try to do that. I did mention the garden a few moments ago, and I thought it would be nice to take a look at one of the flowers that is growing. It is actually a beautiful plant that will grow every year. And this particular plant is called a dahlia. And we're going to have a look at it right now. And there it is. So this is the dahlia that we have growing in the garden. However, unfortunately this year, this particular plant is not looking very well because of all of the intense heat and dry weather that we've had over the past few weeks. So for those asking, Mr. Duncan, we haven't seen your dahlia this year. There it is. But it's not looking very well at the moment, unfortunately. We have give it lots of water. We did give it a lot of water in the evening, but unfortunately during the daytime it dries completely, and by the end of the day, all of the leaves are dry and there is no water left in the pot. So every night we have to put some more water, and we have to water the dahlia almost every day. And there you can see it isn't looking very well, I have to say. This year Mr. Steve's lovely dahlia is not looking very healthy. But I do remember on Sunday, somebody on Sunday mentioned that they have some dahlias growing in their garden. So that's the reason why I'm showing that today. Sadly, because of the hot weather and because of the extreme dry heat that we've had here, many of the plants have been suffering. In fact, I can tell you something now. In the southeast of England, they've had no rain for almost, I think it's almost 2 months. They've had no rain, and now it's really dry. In fact, certain parts of the southeast of England have now started to ban the use of hose pipes. So people have been told that they can't go into the garden to water their plants. And that is in the southeast of England. So officially, in the southeast of England, there is a shortage of water. Fortunately, around here, we don't have that problem. There is still plenty of water in this particular area. So at the moment, there are no restrictions, no bans, nothing. So we can still water our plants in the evening. Hello, Safia. Oh, Safia says, please can you give me a special hello? It is my third time here. Hello, Safia. Or should I say, hello, Safia. It's nice to see you again with your third visit to my live stream. Thank you very much. Was that okay? Did you enjoy that? I hope so. Yes, the dahlias. Oh, you could see that beautiful dahlia just outside the window. Yes, the dahlia that we have at the back of the house is just outside the kitchen window. So every day we can look outside and enjoy the sight of the dahlia. Oh, talking of plants, I'm going to show you now a very beautiful garden. This is not my garden that I'm about to show you, but this is a beautiful garden that is in Much Wenlock, the place where I live. Would you like to have a look at it? So look at this. So this is a garden, and I suppose you would describe this as a wild garden. So everything that you can see in that particular garden, they are all meadow plants, such as heather. So there is a lot of heather you can see at the front of the house. And this is a very well-known house. In fact, this particular house has been on television many times because of the beautiful garden that surrounds the property. So if you look closely, you can see there are lots of wild flowers. So the people who own this particular house have decided to grow lots of wild flowers. Heather. You can see there are some purple heathers, and I think also some pink heathers as well. But this particular house is in Much Wenlock, and it's very well known. A lot of tourists who come to visit Much Wenlock, they often go to this house and stand outside, and they will take photographs because, well, it's quite nice, to be honest. It is a stunning garden. I'm sure you will agree that it is a rather nice garden. Hello, Isabella. Isabella Burmistrak. Hello to you. I think I am here for the first time. Hello to Poland, and also hello to Isabella. Oh, I suppose I should say, welcome, Isabella. It's nice to see you here. I hope you enjoy the show. And if you don't, please don't go. Hello also to Vittoria as well. What a beautiful original house. Yes, the house that I just showed you is actually one of the original cottages that was built. I think maybe it's around maybe 150 years, 120 years perhaps. So many of the cottages that were built originally are over 100 years old, and some of them are in very good condition. They have been restored, which is quite nice. Another quick nature video that I want to show you is in the front garden of my house. A lot of people will remember that there is a very unusual plant growing in my front garden. Would you like to have a look at it? So this is something that I filmed on Monday in my front garden. And this particular plant is one that returns every year to say hello. And this year, it looks magnificent. So this particular plant is called a cardoon, or some people call it a Cinara cardunculus. It can also be called the artichoke thistle, the cardone, the cardoni, the cardunny, or the cardi. So this particular type of plant is a thistle. And you can see at the moment they are growing quite fast. They love the hot weather. They like the dry weather. So this particular plant really does enjoy the dry season. And there you can see a lovely close-up shot of that particular plant. But the reason why I'm showing you this is because this year it has gone crazy. I've never seen it grow so well. In fact, at the moment it is taller than me, and I'm over 6 foot. So this particular plant is very tall at the moment, and it seems to be thriving. I like that word, thrive. If something is thriving, it means it is living, it is surviving, it is very healthy. Something that thrives is something that survives. Something that stays in very good health is something that is thriving. So there you can see a particular plant called a cardoon. And the reason why we bought this particular plant is because it is called a cardunculus. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? So during the summer months, there will be some lovely purple flowers that open out. And these particular flowers drive the bees crazy. The bees love these plants very much. So the reason why we bought this is because it has the word dunk in the name. Because, of course, my name is Duncan. And we couldn't resist buying it. So it's nice to see this year at least one of the plants in the garden is doing well. In fact, it's looking rather healthy at the moment. Very nice. I hope you enjoyed that. I'm showing you a lot of things at the moment. Today we are looking at words and phrases connected to way. The way to do something. The way to find a place. The method of doing something. How you do it. Your behavior. So all of those things can be used when we are talking about the way you do something, the way you move, the way you behave. All of that coming a little bit later on. Of course, I just mentioned nature, and it would not be a live English stream without seeing some of the beautiful nature that exists in this particular area. It has been a busy time in the garden this year, especially with the birds. The breeding season for many birds is now coming to an end. But I have to say, one of the most successful breeding seasons for one particular bird, at least, has been the robin. I can't remember a time where I've seen so many robins in the garden. In fact, a couple of days ago, I was watching all of the young robins coming into the garden to feed, but also there were many adults as well. And at one moment, there must have been about seven or eight robins all feeding at the same time, which is very unusual. Because I have to say, robins are not very sociable animals. They don't normally like other birds. And quite often they don't like other robins. So I was surprised to find so many robins feeding in the garden the other day. A very unusual sight. Unfortunately, I didn't have time to film it. But it was quite remarkable. Another bird that has done very well this year during the breeding season is the blackbird. There are many young blackbirds. Lots of blackbirds this year have been produced. They have hatched out from their little eggs. So it's been a very good year for two particular birds, the blackbird and the robin. They seem to have had a very successful year with breeding and also raising their young. A little bit more nature? Of course, yes, no problem. If you want to have some more nature, then don't worry. We can have some. I won't complain about that. It would appear that a lot of people seem to like that particular video. The cows at the back of the house, now that was around 2 years ago. So the cows that we have now at the back of the house are completely different cows. But those were the cows that we had with us for a few months way back in, I think it was 2020 during the pandemic. And there were some cows at the back of the house, and we had a lot of fun moments watching them, feeding them. And sometimes we were chased by the cows. A lot of people are actually afraid of cows. They always worry that maybe the cow will chase them, or maybe will trample over them with their big heavy feet. The only time you have to really worry about cows is if they have young cows, if they have calves with them. So if there are cows in a field with young cows, my advice is always stay away. Don't go near them, because that is one of the few times that a cow will actually attack a person. One of the few times. There aren't many times that a cow will actually attack a human being, but I can guarantee one of them is when the cows are looking after their young. They become very defensive. And if a person will walk through the field, if they insist on walking through the field, you are literally putting your life at risk. There have been incidents where people have been trampled to death by cows who have been disturbed when they are trying to look after their young. The nature around you is wonderful, Mr. Duncan. Thank you, Beatrice. You are very kind to say that. I've always wanted to live in the countryside since I was a child. Now, I was very lucky when I was young because the place where we lived was very close to an area that was near a river. So we could actually walk for just a few moments from the house where I was raised, and we could just go to this lovely meadow area, and there was also a river there as well. In fact, we used to go fishing in the river, but not for fish. We used to actually fish for a certain type of, I suppose you would call it a shellfish, called a crayfish. Crayfish. Have you ever seen a crayfish? They are quite unusual creatures. They look a little bit, they're not exactly the same, but they look a little bit like a lobster. But they are actually black. And we used to go fishing for crayfish. And what we would do, we would take a piece of string and we would put it in the water with a tiny piece of meat on the end. And then the crayfish would come up and they would try to grab hold of the meat with their claws. And then the string would move and you would take the string out of the water. And there you would have a crayfish on the end of your string. So it was always interesting to do that. And of course, we did not keep them. We put them back in the water afterwards. But it was a bit of fun. A nice little innocent childhood game that we used to play. But no crayfish were harmed during our playtime. You will be pleased to hear. Hello to... Oh, hello, Love Love. Hello, Love Love. Nice to see you here. The cows made me remember when I lived in my native country, Guatemala. I used to live in a farm and we had lots of cows. I have a secret fantasy. Would you like to know what my secret fantasy is? My little fantasy is to work on a farm. Maybe not permanently, but maybe just for a few weeks, just to help out. And there are some local farms around here, and I've always wanted to actually spend a few weeks helping a farmer to do some of their work or some of their chores. I don't know why. I quite like the idea. I like the idea of maybe one day. I wish this fly would leave me alone. There's a fly now buzzing around me, and it's very annoying. Yes, I would love to work on a farm, maybe for a few weeks. We will see what happens in the future. Hello, Arsh Bar, or Arsh Bra. Hello to you. Nice to see you back here today. Unless, of course, it is your first time on the live chat. Today we are looking at one particular subject. We will be looking at the subject of ways. The way to do something. The way to somewhere, the way you behave. All of that coming up a little bit later on, in fact, in a few moments' time, right after this. Thank you. the rabbits, some of them young, some of them not so young, in the garden. Although, to be honest, I haven't seen them for quite a while, so maybe they are they are in the woods at the moment, enjoying the shade. It is English Addict with me, Mr. Duncan. Hello. Thank you for joining me on this Wednesday. We have now entered August. Wow. This year does seem to be going by quite quickly. And it is my birthday in 9 days. 9 days from now. It is my birthday. I wonder if I will get lots of lovely cards and greetings and maybe even some donations as well. That would be ever so nice. And then I can carry on doing this for a little bit longer. Is that a good idea? I hope so. Today we are looking at a particular subject. I always like to show you something on Wednesdays, a certain phrase or a certain topic. And today we are looking at words and phrases connected to way. And of course, this word can be used in many ways. It can be defined in many ways. It can be used in many ways as well. So when we look at the word way, often we are referring to the route. When we say route, we mean the direction or path, or maybe a certain direction that you have to follow, or something you have to do to get from one place to another. We describe it as the way. Maybe a method, the way you do something. Maybe direction, and very similar to route. So we often think of following a route and going in a certain direction as the same thing, very similar. You go in a certain direction, you follow a certain route, you go in a certain way, you follow that way. Also, we might say a person's manner, the way they behave, the way they behave towards other people, their attitude. And let's have a closer look, shall we? The path to or from something or somewhere. For example, you might say you need to go this way. You need to go that way. So when we talk about the way in which a person must move or travel, we are saying you must go that way. You must go this way. Quite often, if we are giving two possibilities or two ways, we will say you can go that way, or you can go this way. You can go this way, or you can go that way. So quite often we will say this or that. You need to go this way. You can go this way. You can go that way. You need to go this way. You need to follow this path. You need to follow this particular route to get from one place to another. The method or process to do something, or the process of doing something. There is an easy way to grow tomatoes. This is the way to grow tomatoes. So in these sentences, the word way is being used to mean method or the process of doing something. We are saying that if you follow these instructions, or if you do something with this method, then that is the best way to do it. So when we use the word way, we are defining the method or the process to do something. Another way of using way can be an instruction given as a guide. So maybe you are showing someone how to do something. You are showing them the way to do it. For example, you can see here, you can see there are some instructions for a remote control. It is showing you the way to use it. So this particular instruction is showing you how to do it, the way to do it. We can also have a map as well. You can have a map. A map is something that is very useful, as you can see. A map is something that can be used quite often when you want to get from one place to another. You are finding your way. You are going in a certain direction. Can you tell me the way to the nearest ATM? Here, let me show you the way there. This map will show you the way. So when we talk about way, in this particular sense, we are talking about a guide to finding somewhere, a guide to getting from one place to another. Or, of course, we can use it as an instruction as well. Another use of way, maybe a person's attitude or manner. So the attitude or the manner of a person can also be described as their way, the way they behave, the way they treat other people, their attitude or their manner. You have a strange way of eating your food. In that sentence, we are saying that the person we are talking to eats their food in a very unusual way. Their method of eating is unusual. They have a very strange way of eating. Some people say, Mr. Duncan, you have a strange way of teaching English. It is very strange. We can also use this positively. The way you treat other people is amazing. So maybe if you are offering a compliment, maybe you want to say something nice to another person, you are describing the way a person behaves towards other people. The way you treat other people is amazing. We are describing that person's manner, the way they behave, the way they treat other people. It is a compliment. I suppose you might say that someone can have a strange way of doing something. In that particular sentence, we are saying that the thing they are doing is unusual or odd. In this particular sense, the word way can mean to gain entry to or exit from a place. So you are trying to go in or you are trying to go out. You are entering, you are leaving, you are going in or you are going out. Can you show me the way in to the building? Can you show me the way into the building? What is the quickest way out of the building? So we can have a way in, which is often referred to as an entrance, or you can have the way out, which is often described as an exit. The way out is an exit. We can also have a list of methods. Many ways of doing something. Many ways of carrying out a certain task. For example, there are many ways to save money, many ways to keep your money safe. Maybe in the future you will need that money, the money that you save, and there are many ways to do it, many methods of doing it. Here is a list of ways to relax yourself. I know these days we often think of life as being stressful, something that is hard to do, something that is hard or difficult to cope with. Maybe you need to find a way to relax. You need to find a method. The way of doing something is the method, how you do it. As I mentioned a few moments ago, the way in or out is an entrance or an exit, a doorway, an open window, a hole. So all of these things can be entered. You can go in. It can be a way in, or it can be a way out. It can be an exit, the way in or the way out. Another way of using way, another way of using way, a guide to achieving something. So maybe the way to make friends, something that is helping you to achieve something, maybe a guide, maybe something that will help you. Quite often we talk about tips. When we talk about a tip, quite often we are talking about something that is said, a piece of advice that is given to someone. You are suggesting a way of doing it. That is your suggestion. So quite often we will have some sort of guide to achieving something. For example, the way to make friends. It's not easy making friends. It isn't. And can I just say, the older you get, the harder it becomes to make friends. So maybe you are looking for an easy way, or maybe some ideas or some suggestions to help you to make friends. Also, we have another interesting phrase which can also be shown as a sign. The sign says, give way. To give way means to move aside or allow someone to pass by. Maybe you are at a junction in the road and you have to wait for the other traffic to go by before you can pull out, before you can go into the other road. You have to give way. So if you give way, it means you move aside or you allow someone to pass by. And quite often in the UK, as you drive around the roads, you will see this sign all over the place. We call it a give way sign. It means you have to wait until the other traffic has passed by. Some great phrases now. Some lovely phrases using the word way. You are on the way up. A person who is on the way up is a person whose life or job is improving. Their life is getting better. You are on the way up. We often use this when we are talking about a person who has become successful, or maybe they are gaining success as they do their job. So maybe in your job you get a promotion, maybe you get a higher position in the company that you work for. You can say that you are on the way up. I'm on the way up. My boss has given me a promotion and also some extra pay. I'm on the way up. You might also say that you are on the way up the ladder. You are climbing the ladder of success. Here's another interesting phrase that we often use in English. Where there is a will, there is a way. In this particular sentence, the word will means the determination that you have to do something. So your will is your determination, something you want to do. You are very keen. You are determined to do that thing. We often describe it as a person's will, something they really want, something they want to do. is a person's will. Where there is a will, there is a way. This means a thing sought can be found. So if you really want something, if you really want to do something, you will always find a way to do it. Always. Where there is a will, there is a way. Another way of describing this phrase, an aim made can find its mark. So maybe something you are aiming for, something you want to do, something you want to carry out in the future. It is your aim. Where there is a will, there is a way. If you really want it, you can get it. You can have it. We can also say that this particular phrase refers to perseverance. Perseverance equals solution. The more you try, the harder you work, the more the chance of you achieving your goals. Where there is a will, there is a way. If you really want something, you will find a way to get it. To look for a way out. Oh yes, we've all done this in our life. Maybe you've been invited to a party. Maybe there is a party that you don't want to go to, and you are finding a way out. In this particular phrase, we are saying that we are looking for a reason not to do something. We are trying to find a way out. We do not want to do it. So we are trying to find a reason or an excuse not to do it. I must find a way out of going to the party. I must find a way out of going to the party. In that sentence, we are saying that we don't want to go to the party. I don't want to go. Now I have to find a reason not to go. I am looking for a way out. Something you don't want to do. We often look for a way out. We don't want to do it. Another word we can use sometimes in this situation is loophole. Can you see what I've done here? I've written this down in my beautiful handwriting. Loophole. So a way out of doing something, or a way out of something that you are trying to escape, we can describe it as a loophole. Maybe a contract that you've signed and you are trying to find a way out of that contract. You are looking for a loophole. You are trying to find a way out of doing that particular thing. Here is a phrase that we often say when we want to congratulate someone. Maybe a person has done very well. Maybe they have succeeded in doing something. Maybe they've done very well in their exams. Maybe they've had a promotion at work. You might say, way to go. Way to go. Quite often used in American English. So in American English, people will say, way to go. When we are saying, good job, well done, way to go, you've succeeded, and I'm pleased for you, way to go. Here are some more phrases. We are using the word way in both of these examples. We still have a way to go before lunchtime. We still have a way to go before we arrive. In these two sentences, we are expressing a long time or a long distance. So in the first phrase, if you look very closely, if I can find it, in the first phrase there, we are talking about time. It will be a long time before lunchtime. We still have a way to go before lunchtime. That means there is still a long time to go. We are not having lunch yet. There is still lots of time to wait. And this one, we still have a way to go before we arrive. This means long distance. So in this particular sentence, we are saying there is still a long way with the distance. We will not get to the house. We will not arrive for a very long time. We still have a way to go. There is still a long distance ahead. We often describe road directions, directions on the road, as a way. You are looking for a way. Maybe you have to turn in a certain direction. You have to go a certain way along the road. Maybe you have to turn left or turn right. You have to go that way or this way. This way or that way. You have to go in a certain direction. You have to take a certain way. An instruction given to show the direction one must travel in. For example, on a road or path. So once again, we are talking about direction and also instruction. You are being instructed. You are being told which way to travel or which way to go. Finally, this is one that is often used in business for those learning business English. The road ahead. Oh. When we talk about the road ahead, we are talking about the future. The road ahead. We are using this figuratively. So we are talking about the future, our plans, the things we plan to do in the future. The road ahead. The way in which we are going. So the way can be also defined as the future. The road ahead is the way ahead. The road before us is the way we must travel. And quite often we use this to show the future, something we plan to do in the future. The way ahead. I hope your future will be bright and sunny, just like the weather is today here in the UK. I will be going in a few moments. Another one I didn't mention, there is another one. A person can be way ahead. It means they are in front. So a person who is way ahead of another person is in front of them. They are further ahead. They are in front. They are further away. The other person is behind. But you are way ahead. That, as they say, is that. It is time for me to make my way out of the studio and to allow you to continue with the rest of your Wednesday. I hope your Wednesday will be nice and lovely. I hope something nice will happen today to put a smile on your face. And I hope also you've enjoyed this as well. Thank you very much for your company. Vitas mentions a song by Greg Ullman. Of course, the Ullman brothers were very popular. Don't stand in my way. Ah, yes. If you stand in a person's way, it means you are in their path. You are blocking their way. You are trying to move forward, but something is in the way. It is in front of you. Something that is blocking you is in the way. Good one. I like that one. Thank you very much for your company. Some interesting messages. I will read your messages later. I don't always have a chance to look at the live stream when I'm on, but I promise I do look at all of the messages later on, and it always puts a big smile on my face. Thank you very much for your company. It is now 3:10 here in the UK, and I am about to say goodbye, but I hope you've enjoyed today's live stream. And if you haven't watched my new video that I posted yesterday, then I suggest you watch it, if you don't mind. This is Mr. Duncan saying thanks for watching, and maybe in the future you will be able to get one of these lovely t-shirts. We will see what happens. We are back on Sunday. Is that okay? Do you mind? I will be back with you on Sunday. In fact, you can catch me on YouTube every Sunday and Wednesday from 2 p.m. UK time. I will be back with you on Sunday, and Mr. Steve will be here as well, joining us live in the studio. Thank you very much for your company. Enjoy your day. Have a super duper time. And keep that smile upon your face as you walk amongst the human race. And I will see you at 2 p.m. this Sunday. I hope you can make it. And of course, until the next time we meet here, you know what's coming next. Yes, you do. Ta-ta for now.